Okay guys, this is an unboxing video about the Redragon K553 mechanical keyboard that I purchased from Amazon for approximately $45. Let's open it up and take a look. Okay, the first thing, the packaging looks pretty nice. I mean, we're more about substance than style, so we're not going to worry too much about the packaging, but it does make a good first impression. I see it comes with an 18-month warranty. I don't know much about this company, so I can't say whether they honor warranties or not, but at least it's better than some companies. At least it's an 18-month, you might be able to do something in case it becomes defective. The packaging looks nice. Let's see what it says about it on the back. Something about a logo inscription version. Two bracket, that's the feet. Windows lock key. Function keys. Multimedia keys, brightness and breathing for the LEDs, backlight control, breathing light control, caps lock and scroll lock indicators, that's helpful, double injection keycaps, and a gold-plated USB connector. This is an 87-key keyboard. It does not have the numerical keypad. I wanted a little more real estate on my desktop. That's the reason why I chose this. They do make a similar keyboard that does have the numerical keypad built into it. I think it's identical except for that. So if you think you're going to like it based upon this video and you want the keypad, you can just get the other model. It's on the Redragon website. I took a look at it myself but decided that I don't use the numerical keypad enough to make it worthwhile. I see the multi-language. You have English, French, not sure, it looks like Italian, Spanish, maybe Chinese, Chinese, Japanese, not sure about the other one. Nice first impression in terms of the packaging. So let's see what it says on the front. Full without conflict, not sure what that means. The key exchange means you can pop these keys off and you can swap these arrow keys for these ones over here if you have a desire for that. 12 multimedia, the Windows key lock, the gold plated, the breathe light, and also aluminum chassis. This one was the slightly upgraded model that has an aluminum chassis. It was only $5 difference. I figured for the $5 I'd just go with the supposedly better model. I don't know whether it was worth the $5 or not, but I figured for $5 it was worthwhile. Okay, let's open it up. Okay, the first thing you notice, you have the key button puller. That might be useful someday. Bubble wrap. Everybody likes bubble wrap. Okay, so there it is. You can see the size in relation to my current keyboard, which is an HP stock keyboard that simply came with this cheap HP computer. It's quite a bit different in size. Mainly just the numerical keypad here. You can see that. That's the main difference. You don't have that. So it does save a lot of real estate on the desktop. Okay, let's see how we think it's going to perform. First thing we'll notice is it does have the gold-plated USB connector, although I will say that this does look like a very, very cheap rendition of a gold plating. It's almost silver, so I wouldn't, by far, it is not the best gold-plated connector that I've seen. But, I mean, I'm not going to be plugging this in and out a lot. This would be irrelevant to me. But if we're judging it based upon that, it also does not have a cloth cable, which I do tend to like the cloth cables better, but I suppose at this price range you're maybe not going to get that. It does have the Velcro strap to keep it nice and neatly tied up. I suppose that's useful, although a penny cable tie would work just as well, so again, that's almost irrelevant. So taking a look at this, it looks nice, clean. I don't see any obvious manufacturing defects. So that's good. Let's flip it over, see what we got on the back. Looks nice on the back. Pop open the feet. So we've got some rubber tabs on the bottom, some rubber pads on the feet to keep it from sliding around. And again, as you can try to see here, this is the model K553, and it also goes by USAS, USAS, made by Redragon. Okay, again, this requires 5 volt, 200 milliamps, so if you're connecting it up to a shared USB port that has other devices draining power, the average USB port's going to handle about 500 milliamps, so this takes 200. Probably that would be only if you're using the LEDs at their brightest setting continuously, so there may be some wiggle room on this power requirement, but just to be safe, you'd want to make sure you don't exceed the 500 milliamps, so this requires 200 milliamps. Okay, let's do just a little test on the keyboard, see how it sounds. So right off the bat, I can say that it does sound substantially better and feel substantially better than this stock junky HP keyboard, membrane keyboard that this computer came with that I have. So my first impression is that this is going to be a big upgrade. Obviously, I have no way to know how long it's going to last and how durable the product's going to be yet, but first impression so far is that the keys have a very nice touch to them, and overall seems like it'd be much better to type on in the occasional gaming. Okay, here's a little test that I did to see how much downward pressure it takes in order to activate the switches. So this is exactly what it takes to reliably activate a button switch on this keyboard. We'll figure it out right now. 24 pennies and 3 dimes. So it took 24 pennies and 3 dimes to reliably press down and activate one of these button switches. I believe these are the blue switches that imitation cherry switches, the blue ones that are made by the company that starts with an O. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, but that's what it takes. I don't know if that's considered a lot or not. I'll weigh this amount and let you know here. This weighs 2.4 ounces the amount of coins that it took to activate one of the switches. And so if you see there, 2.4 ounces equals approximately 68 grams. So I believe that the activation is rated at around 60 grams. So on the keyboard that I have and the exact button, I mean, it may be slightly different from button to button, but the button that I tried was exactly 68 grams that it took to reliably activate it. Okay, let's go ahead and plug it into my USB hub and see what we get. Okay, so there you go. You see it's already lit up. Yes, there you go. Getting some brightness difference there. Well, that actually seems to turn, it's turning it into the breathing pattern. That seems to turn it off. So we're cycling through the different programs, turns it on, turns it off. So that's in the breathing mode, that's in the fixed mode, that must be your brightness, so that's maximum brightness, there we have all the way off, and there's probably where I'll run it with just a little bit of brightness activated. Go up here and try to type something, see what we get. Okay, yep, it works good. This keyboard works for sure. Has a nice feel to it. Overall, first impressions are very positive. I would have to say that this is probably a keeper. So right now I'd say 2 thumbs up, recommended. Not sure what else to show on it. It's a keyboard. Like I say, there's nothing fancy or frilly about it. It's nice. I wanted a mechanical keyboard. I grew up with those. I'm a computer user from the late 70s and 80s, so I'm used to the old school keyboards. I find that the keyboards have been increasingly getting worse and worse as time goes on. And I just wanted something that was more old school and had a little more positive feel to it. And the nice thing about these 87 key keyboards is that I don't have to deal with the keypad. So overall, right now, 2 thumbs up. I give it a good recommendation. And if anything comes up in the future, I'll let you know. Thanks for watching, and hopefully you got something out of the video. Take care. Goodbye.